Hi everyone, the HSC exam has been postponed due to the spread of COVID-19. Everyone is probably wondering when the lockdown will finally end and why our Minister Gladys decided to lift some restrictions when 70% of the New South Wales population above 12 years old has received their double doses. Today, I will be using an oversimplified mathematic model on spread of infectious disease to explain why the government has decided this seemingly arbitrary percentage goal. We're going to start off by defining something called basic reproduction number. Sometimes it's what we call basic reproduction ratios. There are different methods to calculate it. For example, Singapore has calculated this as exponentially e to the power of constant, which is the growth rate, times the expected value minus half k square times the standard deviation square, which is the variance. So what R0 exactly mean? R0 means the expected number of the new cases infected by one person. The assumption is everyone is susceptible to the disease and the government or us is doing nothing. For example, there's no lockdowns and there's no wearing mask. There are three different critical cases for R0. Obviously, R0 cannot be negative. Otherwise, it seems weird because the disease starts curing people, right? So the first case is where R0 is between 0 to 1. Let's just take a number where R0 is equal to 0.2. So this means on average, if there are 5 infected people, it will pass down to one person. And that one person will pass down to 0.2. And eventually no more new cases will be generated, which means the person got infected will stabilize and got recovered. The second case is where R0 is approximately equal to 1. This means the infected people are more or less stay the same. There will be some minor oscillation around the equilibrium. This is what we call an endemic. And one of the examples is the influenza. That's why we're getting our vaccine every year for. The last case is where the problem is, where R0 is become bigger than 1. That's what we call an epidemic. What does this mean is there are more new cases generated than previous. This type of R0 will produce an exponential growth initially, which is pretty scary. Let's say R0 is equal to 4 for now. We're going to use the same number of cases. So 5 people will pass down to 20 people and 20 people will pass down to 80 people. Now, theoretically, if we're doing nothing, and if everyone is susceptible to the disease, there's going to be two consequences where people either dies or people gets immune. Under the immune category, there's gonna be 3 different cases where we have people got vaccinated and people got infected, but they recovered, which means they might have a possible immune. So infected and they got recovered. And the last case is where the person is lucky, is naturally born with immune. So natural. Note in either case, the susceptible population decreases. This is why the growth isn't exponential forever, which would be a disaster and will tend to be more like a logistical growth model. Since COVID-19 starts in January 2020, it's considered to be a relatively new virus where scientists decide the R0 is approximately equal to 3. However, the Delta variant is much more bigger than that, which is roughly between 5 to 8. Now you understand what the reproduction number is, but exactly how long does it take for the infected person to generate new cases? 1 day, 2 days, 1 month. That would be a very crucial factor because let's say COVID-19 only generates 1 case per decade, we wouldn't be worried, right? Thus, we need to understand another concept in epidemiology, which is something called serial interval. So what is it? Now say we have an infected person, which is patient zero. It takes time to develop the symptoms such as fever and cough. During that time, this is what we know an incubation period, where WHO says it's around 5 to 6 days in average, but might take to 14 days. But let's take 5 days for now, where he shows the symptom. And that's 5 days. But during the 5 days, he doesn't know he got infected. So he went out for grocery shopping and he meets patient number one, which is P1. So bear in mind, patient number one is not necessarily getting infected when P0 shows the symptom. Patient number one can get infected anywhere between the incubation period, right? It takes another 5 days for patient one to show their symptom. Now, the time from when P0, patient zero, first shows the symptom to patient one shows the symptom is what we know as a serial interval. And let's quickly take the average, n equal to 3 days. So what can we do to prevent the virus spreading? Last year, the UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson said, Britain will not close schools or cancel large gatherings in response to the virus. And instead, every English male should be prepared to lose their loved ones. Sounds pretty sad. At the time, they don't have any vaccination. So they are going to use a thing called herd immunity to getting through this. Now, what is it? Well, they calculated 60% of their British population will be infected. Remember, they are considering everyone get infected and recovered will become immune, right? So for example, if you have 10 people and those people are got infected and got recovered, and there are a few people are still not infected, which is susceptible to the disease. So let's say 4 people, yep. So the susceptible people will be spreading disease. However, they are probably surrounded by the people who got immune. Yep. So in other words, they not only protect the people who's already immune, but also the people who is susceptible. And the good news for now is, on top of the herd immunity, we also have the vaccine, right? So now suppose the proportion of the immunized people of a population P, where P is those people now all together. And we can see the people who are still susceptible is 1 minus P. In other words, one infected person can only infect R0, the reproduction number, times the people who's susceptible to the disease. So what do we want that to come out of? We want that to be less than one, right? Because we want less and less cases. So let's make that less than one. By simple rearrangement, we are able to see P must be bigger than 1 minus 1 over R0, where R0 is approximately 5 for delta strain. So we are getting 80% of people that need to get immune, which means the 70% of the double dose rate should be very reasonable, because we have people got infected and recovered, and we have people naturally born immune. By looking at this 2 days data, the effective R0, the number has been reduced to 1 due to the increasing rate of the people getting vaccinated, which means the infected population will be stabilized, which is good news. Unfortunately, after observing adverse reaction to the vaccine, such as fatigue or in extreme case death, people start think, oh, if I wait until everyone else gets vaccinated, I will be well protected. Therefore, I don't need to get vaccinated. But if everyone thinks like this, which means the disease will eventually affect everyone, right? At the end, I like to make an easy math question that relates to your HSC. Let's start off by using a real scenario. Here we have a Bondi limo driver named Michael. He was tested positive in mid-June 2020, and he's considered to be the zeros patient. He was only fined by $500, but compared to what we lost here, billions dollars, it's nearly nothing, right? So let's assume everyone is susceptible to this disease and the government is doing nothing, so we can use the R0. Let's assume that, and R0 in this case is equal to 5, which we're gonna consider the delta strain, and the serial interval is still 3 days on average. And we can take the population of Sydney equal to 5 million, which is 5 times 10 to the power 6. My question is, suppose he is the only case to start with and everyone else is susceptible, how long would it take COVID-19 to infect everyone in Sydney if we're doing nothing? You can pause the video if you want to try. Let's start with himself, which is one. He is going to infect 5 to the power of 1 people and 5 to the power of 2 people, so on and so forth. But just be very careful, since the first term is the zeros patient, or we can call it, it's the first generation of the zeros patient. After n generation, you should end with 5 to the power of n minus 1 people, right? So by taking a partial sum of GP, we are able to get a r the power of n, since there are n terms on the left, minus 1 over r minus 1. We are able to equate this fraction into the population of the cine, which is 5 to the power of n minus 1 over 4, which is equal to 5 times 10 to the power of 6. And guess what n comes out to be? N comes out to be only 10 days if we sit back and doing nothing, which is pretty scary, right? Of course, the true model of this is much more complicated than what I've shown here today. Other factors like rate of the contact, recovery time, degree of the contagiousness, or someone living in the rural area never come out. But hopefully this gives you guys a broad idea of what epidemiology is like and why it's important we understand it. And most importantly, why getting vaccinated is a must. Thank you for watching.